Something that we do every year, which is one of the most important things we do every year, is we shine the light on a member of our community who is so deserving of recognition. This year, the Long Beach International Film Festival presents its Wiesenberg Elevich Community Achievement Award to James Hodge for his acts of selflessness and endless effort to better his community through his work on behalf of the Long Beach MLK Center. He demonstrates his love for people by giving back to the community and affecting the lives of many through activism and outreach.
This is the Wiesenberg Elevich Award, because service to Long Beach is measured by the two men after whom this award is named. And I want everyone to think about that for a second. Right? The people who get this award, people that are lucky enough to receive the Wiesenberg Elevich Award, you know, could have a lifetime of service. James is barely 40 years old. You know, I'm also trying to make up for lost time. I voted against James in 1994 for homecoming king. I didn't think he had what it took, but I regret that, and I'm glad to see that he's getting the recognition now that he deserves. James fights the fight for those in the community who can't speak for themselves.
To have this award go to James this year, it was probably such an easy choice and such a logical choice. You know, in the last 5.5 years, we've all been through a lot together, and James was front and center for that. In the days after the storm, I think about one of my enduring memories is the James Hodge honorary megaphone. which I now carry around a version of that in my city truck as insurance in case we ever need to remind everybody to evacuate and get off the boardwalk again. But while everybody else was evacuating, James was here, and he ran that distribution site at the MLK, and I can hear in my ears, and I will never forget, the comida caliente, you know, serving several hot meals a day, every day, for months and months on end. So when people needed help most, James was there, the center was there, James was the center.
And he'd worked so hard, but for the community, doing things not only for the Martin Luther King Center, but for everybody. James was a person that always gave of himself. He never said no. James, I couldn't think of a better person to get this honor. I know Larry is here in spirit, looking down and saying, what a wonderful, wonderful person to give this award to. I'm very, very proud that he has done such a wonderful job.
And today, I have to smile because James Hodge. James, I'm going to share us, but you're probably not aware. And my daughter Vicky is here with me today. Today is my wife's anniversary with me. 51 years we were married. She passed away, but I want you to know, it's emotional to me because James has always said, you're my mom and my dad, and we always love James. But I tell you how proud I am. James, today is a special day for you. It's an acknowledgement of who you are and what you do, but you really are a model of what our community is all about.
Just a couple months ago, Dr. Bernice King, Martin Luther King's daughter, was here in Long Beach for their annual fundraiser for the MLK Center. One of the most poignant things that she did say, she looked directly at James and she said, James, everyone here in this room, we all see what you do, but at surface level. She said, God sees everything that you do. And it's very, very true, because there's so many things that his posts don't capture, our eyes don't capture, but it's in the fabric of this community. It's instilled in the youth that are growing up and experiencing the programs that he has at the MLK Center. So it really is an honor and a privilege for us to have you here today and to bestow this award for you.
Thank you so much. I'd like to first of all thank God for this opportunity for receiving an award for what I love doing, and that's just working with the community and helping the community. I would like to thank the Long Beach International Film Festival for such a prestigious award that I'm receiving from two of my biggest role models. Of course, I wish my mom and dad was here with me, but they are here with me in spirit. My mom and dad, after Sandy, They both passed a little bit after that, and I thank God for all of the things that they have instilled in me that I'm able to keep going on and doing some of the things that I saw my mom and dad do so much. I'm happy that I can help just one person. I'm happy that I would not be able to do what I do if it was not for the great team that we have in the community and the staff and volunteers of the Long Beach Martin Luther King Center. I would like to thank all of those that had great words. My great friend, Senator Todd Kominski, who did not vote for me, but I did win the homecoming king in 94. You know. And I'm so honored to have my sister here and my cousin and my niece and family. Give my sister Sandra a round of applause. She is so supportive, and she's just taken like a mom role since my mom had passed, and just there for me every step of the way. So again, to each and every one, and I don't, again, Craig, I thank you for picking, choosing me, however you did, for this award. And I don't think you know that Harvey and his wife there, I always told my mom and dad, that's the second mom and dad to me. You know, I went up to Albany for many years, and I still go. And I tell everybody, yes, Harvey is my dad. How's your dad doing? Now I don't even have to tell him he's my dad. You know, my father used to say, okay, I'll meet him. And they always knew each other. And I just, Harvey has always, always, always been in my corner. And I thank him and his lovely wife. She always stopped what she's doing and just showed me so much love like a son. And always made sure all of the other kids known I was one of the family members. You know, my sister Vicky is here. And love you, Vic. And, you know, when we were going through Sandy and Harvey and his wife stopped in, they saw all that was going on and people were coming to get food every single day and the children were coming to get toiletry items and all of the different items we had. And we were just doing a lot of work, but a small distribution center. Harvey and his wife wrote a $10,000 check, you know, out of their personal money. It was out of their personal money, and I am so honored that someone saw fit to say, you know what, we see what you're doing, and here's a $10,000 check to help the effort in what you're doing. So let us give them another round of applause. I received this award today on behalf of my uncle. I received this, and I love my uncle, Lindsay. And I say to my Uncle Lindsay and family, I love you, and all my family in Florida, I love you. So to each and every one of you children, I love you, I appreciate you. I receive this on behalf of you also for the work that we do, because I can't do any of it by myself. So again, from the east, the west, the north, and the south, one of the cities I love so much is right here in Long Beach. I'm honored to receive this prestigious award. God bless, stay blessed, peace, and love.